It is July 7th, 2012, and I've loaded CleanROM 4.1 Standard Edition onto my HTC One X from Rogers. CleanROM is based on the AT&T 1.85 stock image, so it has Sense and all the normal features with a bunch of the bloatware removed and some new features added. The first of which you're looking at right now, the boot animation has been replaced to tease you with the Jelly Bean boot animation. CleanROM is freely downloadable from www.scottsroms.com, and many, many thanks to user Scrozler or Scrozler on the XDA developer forums who produced this ROM. So in this video, I'd like to show some of the neat features that I noticed on this device compared to the stock image that came on my Rogers phone. So as you can see right away, I've customized it a little bit, but all in all, it looks just like a stock image. You have the Sense widgets. You can scroll through the home screen just like Sense lets you do. Customize your home screens. Scroll through applications. But there are a few goodies in there. The first one I'd like to show you is called the Advanced Power Menu. If you press and hold the power key, it brings up the phone options menu just like you'd expect, with a few additional options. You can take a screenshot, you can turn on or off airplane mode, you can turn on or off the mobile network, as well as you can change the profile from loud to vibrate to silent. So furthermore, if you click in the restart menu, you have the option to reboot in a couple different ways. Most usefully for people like me who like to load ROMs, you can boot into recovery or into the bootloader. There are actually several different ways to take a screenshot. The first way that I just showed you is through the phone options menu. The second way is to press and hold the power and volume down buttons. And the final way is to press and hold the power button and then tap the home key. Whoop. Ironically, all of these screenshots are saved into different locations on the device, but there are several ways to take a screenshot if you ever need to. The second feature is the remap of the capacitive keys on the device. So HTC in stock comes with a back button, a home button, and a task switcher. In CleanROM 4.1, the task switcher button has been remapped to the menu key. I find this particularly useful because in ice cream sandwich apps, sometimes the menu button is up here, which is difficult to reach. Sometimes it's down here, and sometimes it's all the way across the bottom. That inconsistency can be frustrating. I like having the menu key here. It's easy to reach, and it's consistent through all applications. The task switcher is still available by pressing and holding the home key. The third feature I'd like to show is the extended quick settings. So if you swipe down from the top, there's an option here called quick settings. And when you click on that, it gives you a quick way to modify a whole bunch of settings on the device. You can change the various volume levels. You can turn the flashlight on or off, which just turns on the LED. You can set the brightness, turn the radios on or off, airplane mode, change your sound profile, and it also tells you how much free memory you have on the device. And if you click on that, it will give you a little more detailed view. Finally, there are some further modifications that can be loaded on through the recovery to tweak your experience on the device. They're in the SD card in the CleanROM folder. What you do is you boot into recovery and install this zip file, and it will actually go through a installer to let you choose which options you want. The first is to load on the high quality camera, which is very cool because it allows you to take much higher quality photos and otherwise is the same. And it does that by reducing the compression that's applied to the images and the videos. You can load on the Android open source keyboard. If you don't like the key remap, you can change it back to stock, and a few other options that don't apply to me on Rogers. The one that I particularly used is the multitasking. The stock multitasking is fairly crippled, aggressively kills background applications. One is a little less aggressive, and two is less aggressive still. And two is the one that I loaded on, which by and large, is the greatest improvement of the experience on the device. You can also load on a different kernel if you like to. Well, sorry, this is overclocking, so you can overclock the CPU as well. I haven't been brave enough to try that, and I've seen at least one report of someone frying their device overnight, so be careful if you do want to overclock. You can load on a couple different rosy options. Again, I've left stock on, and there are different status bars that you can load with the transparent, and you can also put the percentage in the battery. So this ROM comes with the Google Apps preloaded, so things like the Play Store and Gmail are right there. It also comes rooted, like you would expect, and the Super SU and the Super User apps are available. Now, because I'm on Rogers, I didn't have a data connection at first, and all I had to do to solve that was to go into the APN and manually add the Rogers APN. And these settings can be easily found by searching the XDA developer forums. So, this is CleanROM version 4.1 Standard Edition. Many thanks again go to user Scrozler or Scrozler from the XDA developer forums for creating this ROM and publishing it for free download at www.scottsroms.com.